you're watching now, it's the long boxing exercises performed by Alan. Here you can see the basic exercises and how they're all connected into a series of combinations. Over the past few years, Wushu has become a more internationally known martial art and sport. And in 1985, in mainland China, the Chinese government hosted the first international Wushu competition, inviting countries from Europe and, well, as well, the United States, Mexico. I think all, there was about 20 countries. Ching represented the United States, and she was a bronze medal winner. And I also believe she was the youngest competitor there.
And if you have time, come back here, because I want you.
As of the last few years on the martial arts tournament circuit in America, more and more Wushu performers are competing. And as you can see, they're doing pretty good. It takes a lot of guts to want to use one of these without wearing a football helmet or something. Alright, here we go, folks. Stephan Berwick performing the Praying Mantis set. You gotta keep your eyes on this, it's real quick. Next, Ted will perform a weapon called Pudao, or translated horse cutter. I think that's why his hair is so short. When you do that move, you gotta be real careful. Alright, let's hear it. Next we have John Salvitti performing the single broadsword. John's another Wushu competitor who has recently made his mark on the circuit at different tournaments in the New England area. And he's done rather well for himself. He's a dedicated athlete and he's a good coach. Not an easy thing to do. All right, next we're gonna have Donnie Yen performing staff. This sort of speaks for itself.
Silver medal.
Chinese Wushu Research Institute Performance Group.